So now you were telling me that you've
There's no other organization in the
but
world.
You've been a Jehovah's Witness all your life?
All my life.
And how old are you now?
65.
Uh-huh.
Now, here's the thing. Is that there's no other organization in the world that does what this organization does. I can go onto the internet, to the JW.org site, and if there's a flood in Canada, or if there's a flood in anywhere in the world, we'll know how many Jehovah's Witnesses were affected. So we'll know if any died, we'll know if any lost their homes, we'll know how many Kingdom Halls were damaged, and whether they had to be repaired or rebuilt. When the bombing up in Boston happened, not long after that, on our site, they tell us how many witnesses were involved there or affected.
Do you do an outreach? I mean, do you have a grand kind of support fund, like the national government runs into Katrina and tries to help people, supposedly?
But we have disaster relief. Now, here's what happens with our disaster relief. We don't have to now go out and get funds. The funds are already there.
Right.
So the funds are already ready.
It's interesting. You don't take up collections.
No,
so
it isn't like the boxes you see there on the side?
Uh-huh.
If a person wants to put something in there, they can just go over there and put something in there. Now, what happens is that when a disaster happens...
And you get enough financial support way?
Sure.
Without pressuring people or saying...
No, we don't pass it on plate. We don't... No, nothing like that.
I think that's very impressive.
Yeah, it is. It is indeed.
It is indeed. I understand you're the only... He pointed out to me there's so many treasures in Brooklyn. With Jehovah's Witness, we can hardly get in there. Well, we know it was a special meeting, but he says that Jehovah's Witness is one of the fastest growing.
Yes. In fact, the Catholics just held a conference. I can show you this information in my tablet here.
Really?
We just held a conference on why Jehovah's Witnesses are growing so fast.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And one of the things they said, they gave three reasons. The first reason was because Jehovah's Witnesses are thorough. They go from door to door with their message, so they reach everybody.
Right.
And they're convinced of what they believe.
Right. And you know what my impression is? A third. They actually practice what they preach. I think too many churches do all preaching and no practicing. They all talk about helping the poor, reaching out to others. They turn their back and let their neighbors starve or let people freeze to death in the streets.
Yes. And one of the other things they said, too, is that Jehovah's Witness meets the needs of people.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
So
right.
they talk about...
You are your brother's keeper.
Right, and even like when it comes down to family life, marriage. So if a person is having a problem with their marriage, if they study the Bible, they're going to improve their marriage. If they have a financial problem, right, they're going to improve that. Because they're stopped perhaps using drugs or using alcohol, or if they were alcoholics. And so that money that they were using that way now is now funneled back to the family.
Right.
And they're able to have affordable housing and so forth.
My friend was an alcoholic or drug user and alcoholic from the age of 15 to 4 or 5 years ago. He got one of the place called Hogar over, which is a religious-based organization in New Jersey. But the trouble is most of the guys are there just to avoid going back to jail. They're not really interested in dealing with their problems or stopping their drug or whatever bad habits they have, but it worked for him because he took it seriously. He knew that I have to get rid of this drinking or it's going to kill me. He was drinking 70 ounces a day.
Okay.
And I said, it worked for you, but you know, only worked that place, only worked for like 1%. I have a feeling your success rate here is much higher.
Oh, very well. And here's another thing I want to say. You know, the government talks about transparency.
Mm-hmm.
Even when Obama came into office,
mm-hmm.
he said he was going to be more transparent with the government. Well, true transparency exists in this organization. We are, everything that the governing body of Jehovah's Witnesses does downtown, we're able to basically see. Now, they have a site now called JW Broadcasting.
Uh-huh.
It's like live TV.
Oh, really?
So if you go onto the internet, see that you can get this every month.
And how do you get it? What is it? What's the address?
JW.org. It's called tv.jw.org, I believe.
Okay.
But if you go to JW.org, there's a link.
Okay.
So you just go to the bottom of the first home page that you get to,
uh-huh.
and you'll see JW Broadcasting.
Oh.
And it has movies on there. It has life stories.
So you can literally create an environment in the home where people see movies that inspire.
Absolutely.
Because like for my friend, he has such a negative vision of people. I have Seaspoon Heroes, which is 2 hours long.
Okay.
We're showing great people that go out and do good things for others. Because he has such a negative view. He was raised in an abusive home. His mother had 6 kids by 6 different men and 15 boyfriends in between. And they're all screwed up. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And so I said, you have too negative a view. There are good people. And as a matter of fact, I pointed to George. Look at George taking care of his old mother.
Okay.
You know, I said, They're good people. You can't have this ethos of having it. The worst thing you can do is reproduce, because he thinks humanity is the worst scourge on the face of the earth. I said, that's not a healthy view to have in life. There are good people and there are bad people. I'm not saying there aren't evil, but you've got to appreciate that there are wonderful human beings in the world that do wonderful things.
Absolutely.
For others.
Absolutely. So I think that I'm going to have to stop because I got to take care
of
the things.
That's fine. Thank you very much.
All right.